So the track is back down the high side, and we are set to go. The one to go signal has been given by starter Jason Dykes. His son, Will Dykes, down there on the flag stand as well. Will, the official starter at the Swainsboro Raceway kart track, his first racing job. And Jason is ready to toss green to Kenny Collins, Chris Madden, along with Jonathan Davenport and Aaron Ridley. Four laps, the winner starts on the pole. Let's see what happens. They work out of turn number four, anticipating that green flag. It's out, Davenport goes low. Chris Madden with a high side momentum. He'll take the lead away from Collins. Now the battle goes out between Ridley and Davenport. Aaron Ridley will take the third spot. Davenport tries him. Lap number one will go to Chris Smokey Madden. Davenport takes the number three spot. He's trying to grab second away from Collins and get an outside front row starting spot. He's got two laps to do it. White flag the next time by. Chris Madden, the track record holder, continues his dominance here at Sonora. White flag in the air this time. Davenport running out of real estate and sands in the hourglass if he wants second. One more lap to go. Madden a cakewalk right now here at Sonora and everything he's done. He'll take the field into turn number three. Final time, checker flag waves at pole sitter tonight. Chris Smokey Madden, he'll win the dash. Second will go to Collins. Third to Davenport. Ridley will settle for fourth. So the dominance continues for the 44. Chris Smokey Madden out of Gray Court, South Carolina, puts the Longhorn on the pole tonight for 40 laps. Kenny Collins will join him on the front row starting second. Davenport will start third. Ridley will start fourth. The winner of this first heat race, well, you'll know, he'll be the fifth starter. Laps will be the distance on these heats. Eight-lap heats, so Shane Clanton's going to bring the field to speed with Austin Smith, and here we go, three wide. Well, Michael Page didn't want none of that. He went right after it, and Page is going to try and grab the number two spot away from Smith. It's all Shane Clanton all the time right now. Now Smith will battle back to the inside of Page. Taking a look to the outside is Horton. Top four go. Here comes the alley cap, Ryan Reese. He'll scratch and claw his way on the bottom of the racetrack. Horton with high side momentum. He'll hold the fourth and final transfer spot. Two laps will go on the scoreboard. It's all Clanton. So the 25 of Shane Clanton showing away. Page second. Horton got a little crossed. Brian Reese, the fourth and final transfer spot. Horton on the outside looking in halfway next time. Now Reese will go after Austin Smith for the three spot. Shane Clanton in a cakewalk. Halfway, four in the books, four to go. Reese again will work Austin Smith off of turn four and off into one and two. Brian Reese has got the preferred line. Austin Smith has the momentum. Shane Clanton will see the two to go next time as he continues to show the way. Reese all over the 11 of Smith as Jason Dykes shows him the two to go. White flag the next time by. Again, Reese will take a peek underneath the 11. Nothing doing. Clanton dominating heat race number one. White in the air for the guy they call in the pits, Big Dummy, as he shows the way down the backstretch. He can pretty much shut it off and coast from here. Shane Clanton will win heat race number one. He'll start fifth tonight. Second will go to Michael Page. Austin Smith will hold on for third. And fourth will go to Brian Reese. He's in the dance. So your winner of heat race number one out of Zebulon, Georgia, the World Bank Energy Corporation 25 Capital race car of the Georgia Bulldogs, Shane Clanton. He's in the dance. He'll start fifth. Michael Page makes the big show in the 18X. So does Austin Smith in 11 and the 33 of Brian Reese. If he does not transfer, if he gets in on his own, then problem solved. And it was all academic. So they bunch up side by side, ready to go. Brazil on the inside, the 29 of Fulcher. Cody King along with Payne. Massey and Guy on the back row. Six cars, eight laps, top four go. For pretty much everybody else in the field, you don't finish fourth, you're done for the evening. So here we go. On a four they come, and a great start, we're underway. Fulcher got a big run off of turn number four. Let's see if it pays off. Yes, it will. He'll take the lead. Oh, Payne right on the back bumper of Fulcher, and the caution is out. Now we'll see what this is going to be. So race control telling the 54 Brazil, let's make it a little bit better start. They've got their warning. We'll do it again. They must be side by side at the starting point in order for it to be a good one. So we'll stack them up one more time in four. Jason Dykes looks them over. They look good. Green is out. David Brazil this time with the lead. Fulcher will battle with King for second. King had a pretty good run off of turn number two on the bottom. Close quarters racing. Fulcher had to sacrifice second. Now King got sideways. That's going to allow Fulcher and Payne to close the gap. Good battle going on for the number two spot between three cars. David Brazil showing the way. Mason Massey got a little sideways in turn two. That cost him some real estate, but he will close the gap now on Fulcher. Here comes the 15. It'll be halfway next time by. Brazil, King, Payne, and Fulcher, your top four. Jason Dykes says halfway, guys, cross flags, four and four to go. Time starting to run out on Massey and Kelly Guy. As Fulcher has that fourth and final transfer spot, and he's got distance between himself and Massey. Two to go signal when they come back around. Cody King trying to close the gap on David Brazil, but coming up short. White flag the next time by. Leader David Brazil sees the white flag. Cody King sideways. That allowed Payne to close the gap. All by himself now in the fourth and final transfer spot is Shane Fulcher. He's lost touch with second and third. David Brazil will come home as the winner of heat number two. King will settle for second. Third will go to David Payne. He's in the show. And Shane Fulcher will take the fourth and final transfer spot. So the winner of heat race number two, glad to see him back on a Starkville, Mississippi, the Raging Rebel, David Brazil. Henderson Motorsports, Johnson Trucking, DB Logging. It's a Barry Wright chassis Ford Mustang with Cornette power. So we now have eight drivers locked in from the heats. Eight more to come from these final. Set to go with heat race number three. This ought to be a good one. Casey Roberts on the inside. Donald McIntosh, who's had a pretty good start to 2016 on the outside. Four cars go, eight laps the distance. Out of four they come. Great start for Casey Roberts. Oh, and Donald McIntosh sideways and threw everything away in turn number one. Caution is out. Donald McIntosh getting the warning. So that's going to be his slap on the wrist. We'll do it again. Casey Roberts got a great run off of turn four last time. Let's see if it does it again. And yes, sir, Casey Roberts on the hammer. So he'll lead heat race number three. McIntosh will take McCarter to school down the backstretch. Ricky Williams fourth and final transfer spot early. Darda battling in the back of the pack. Stays ahead of the 311 of Russell Brown Jr. And Roberts drifted up the bank, and McIntosh almost got him. Donald McIntosh threw it pretty hard into turn two, and it almost paid off. Now Russell Brown Jr. will take over the number five spot. He's one closer to transferring. Neither he nor Darda have a provisional coming. Oh, Darda almost got the wall coming out of two. Roberts, your leader. Second is Donald McIntosh. Now Ricky Williams and Mac McCarter will battle for third. Williams comes up just a little short. Casey Roberts taking the field off into turn number three as we're past the halfway point. McIntosh second, McCarter third. Ricky Williams the fourth and final transfer spot, but Russell Brown is digging. Two to go signal this time. Russell Brown Jr. doing everything he can to gain touch with the 17 and have a shot of transferring. It's the only way either one of those two drivers can get in. White flag the next time by. Pressure now coming to Ricky Williams. White flag coming up for Roberts. One more to go. Solid third place run right now. Going on by the 51 of Mac McCarter. Checkered flag away. Casey Roberts will win heat number three. McIntosh will transfer. Mac McCarter will go to the dance, and so will Ricky Williams. The winner of heat number three, the seventh starting spot tonight out of Toccoa, the Cushman Paint and Body, M&S Concrete Concept Graphics, Schaefer's Oil, All-Star Performance Longhorn, the 101 of Casey Roberts. And we have one heat to go. Ready to go for eight quick ones out of turn four. That's not going to happen. We'll try this again.
Or he's in turn four watching the starts.
So they bunch up nice and tight again in four, and this time Armistead on the hammer. And he took Tyler Millwood to school, but Millwood's got a pretty good line down low, holding second. Now Ashton Winger has got himself a third place spot. It's all Armistead all the time, Winger in that second spot. Here comes Millwood and a cat daddy. So Clint Smith has got him a transfer spot for now, but Stacy Bowles trying to take it away. Cat will battle back to the outside. Halfway next time by. Armistead showing the way. Winger second. Millwood third. The halfway signal. It's Joe Armistead Jr., but Ashton Winger is closing the gap. Millwood continues to run in third, and the battle is between Cat Daddy, Clint Smith, and Stacy Bowles. Whoever finishes fourth is in, the other one's out. And it's getting a little bit hotter back there for the fourth spot. Two to go signal this time. Here comes Winger closing the gap on Armistead. White flag coming up. Again, Stacy Bowles to the inside. Cat Daddy will hold him off one more time. Bowles will get a good run off turn two this time. White flag in the air. Fourth spot under protest. One more lap to go. Cat Daddy has got one lap left to get in the show. He's got to hold off Stacy Bowles. Checker flag's going to wave. Armistead's going to win it. Winger's going to come home second. Millwood third. Here they come for the fourth and final transfer spot. The Cat Daddy will get in. So Clint Smith transfers. Your winner of heat number four, Joe Armistead Jr., Ashton Winger goes, Tyler Millwood, and your track champ, the Cat Daddy, Clint Smith, will get the fourth and final transfer spot. He'll start 20th And unofficially, 21st and 22nd by provisional points would be Scott Blomquist in 0 and Shannon Buckingham in the 21. That concludes preliminaries for the Old Man's Garage Spring Nationals. The 40-lapper comes up in between. So as they roll into turn number 4, send them off Sonoma style, ladies and gentlemen. The Old Man's Garage Spring Nationals presented by Schaefer's Oil. 4 wide salute to you race fans. Send them off in style. They're going to keep that formation one more time and then break off. Here we go. Chris Madden and Kenny Collins will lead the field. Mason Dyke says one to go, and we're going to dance for 40 laps and 4 large. Chris Smokey Madden on the pole with Kenny Collins on the outside. 23 drivers will take green. Night number 2 of the Old Man's Garage Spring Nationals about to come to life. We will have a new winner tonight. Who's it going to be? Let's find out in 40 circuits. Madden and Collins out of 4. Green in the air. Here we go. All right, Dwayne, we start the dance, and it's going to be Madden showing the way. Davenport goes straight to second. We got trouble in turn 2. Sideways and no damage. Caution will come out. O'Brien, obviously, the colors are a little bit different, but if you want it just by sponsor, that's it. So let's try it again. Madden and Collins bring the field up to speed out of turn number 4. Jason Dykes looks him over, green in the air. We're going to go dance it for 40. Everybody gets through the front stretch okay. Turn 1 is where it happened last time. Looks good. They've settled down. We're racing.
Good God, Clint Smith just shot out of the can opening on the top side of turn number 2 and just freight train the field. But Chris Mann's going to lead lap 1 with Jonathan Davenport in tow with Kenny Collins.
Cat Daddy started 20th. He's already grabbed 5 positions and continues to carve away at the field as Madden shows the way. Collins in second, third. Right now is Davenport. Now Shane Clanton has gone to the number 4 spot. Ridley has fallen back to 5th, and it's Casey Roberts 6th.
Those guys are screaming hard into the corners. Donald Mack up high, trying to make it dig off. Lightning got into the wall. He's going to fight back as they square off coming out of turn number 4.
There's some contact going on between Tyler Millwood and Donald McIntosh as they almost got together in turn number 3. They've got it all straightened out. Clint Smith continuing to attack the field. But Chris Madden already down the backstretch can see the rear deck lid of Robbie Moses. So it ain't going to be long, and it's going to be Madden in lap traffic.
Here comes Aaron Ridley all over Coconut out of turn number 4. As they squaring off coming to the line. Aaron Ridley's going to take a peek back on him in turns 1 and 2. They're going to continue to dance off turn 2.
It took 5 laps for the field to be spread all the way around the Sonoma Raceway. And now that blue crossover flag is going to get worn out by flagman Jason Dykes as he's going to be waving it the rest of the race. Shane Fulcher almost got sideways as well as he come into contact with the 21 machine of Shannon Buckingham. But we stay green for 7.
Aaron Ridley, a relentless charge against Shane Clanton as they have slugged it out over the last lap and a half going to 2. Lap traffic is going to cause them to split up, but Jason Dykes really working that blue and yellow flag to get these guys up and out of the way.
Yeah, he's going to have a sore arm tonight. That's going to have to go on ice. Speaking of ice in the field, Chris Madden's trying to do it, but here comes Kenny Collins. He has caught the leader who's in traffic. Madden has to make a decision. Will it be the right one? Collins going to try and take advantage. Davenport on the move.
Davenport looking up on the Collins. They head down the backstretch. Madden trying to tread lightly with that terror group known as the back half of the field. He is now going to pass Fulcher and try to stretch away from Kenny Collins.
And Kenny Collins will keep him in his sights. Got him in the crosshairs over in turn number three. To the top side goes Davenport. So he's going to throw the Weaver machine up high, and he's making up real estate.
How much ground he just made up on your second place, man. And here comes Superman. He's about to put on his cape, and he's going to go flying by as he's trying to chase Lois Lane up front, known as Chris. Contact on the front stretch.
Big contact. That time the 21 machine got hit by Millwood. The car slowed up coming out of turn number four. Millwood got a huge piece of him. Dixie double file restart. Chris Madden by himself out front. Kenny Collins on the bottom and Jonathan Davenport up top. Caution lights have been extinguished. We're set to go. Chris Madden will kick the tires, light the fires, and we'll go back to racing. Everybody else picks up the speed. We're underway. Oh, and something happened to Chris Madden. He just bobbled, and three cars go by. Man, a huge bobble over in turn number one to Wayne, and everybody taking advantage. Here comes Superman.
Superman, now put back on that cape up on the top side. Piping it up. Here comes the Georgia boy to the top side. He's going to power around. Kenny Collins fighting back. The pride of Colbert going at it as they square off to the line.
Kenny Collins has got the preferred line, but Davenport had the high side momentum. All of a sudden, Madden is recovered. He'll take the number three spot. He'll go to work. Now Clanton working on Ridley for fourth. Here comes Madden to the inside of Kenny Collins. Power move out of four. He just sidestepped him and dropped him like a bad habit.
Oh, man. Hit him with a left. Hit him with a right. Knock him out like it's fight night. Here comes Coconut laying it all over Ridley in three and four. But that battle for second getting real good as they come to the line.
Shane Clanton is working the bottom of the racetrack. Ridley will stay center groove, and it is all Davenport right now. So Randy Weaver smiling, seeing his car out front. Weaver doing the crew chiefing tonight on the 116. I don't think he's got to tell much to Davenport right now. And trouble on Mac McCarter. McCarter slows. We're going to get caution. Yellow flag out for Mac McCarter. So all the momentum, all the lead that Davenport had has just went by the wayside. Smoke is back in second.
Look, you got to give a huge shout out to Kenny Collins having almost a career run for him in these
right now
series.
To Joe Armistead Jr. sitting there inside the top 10. Cody King gets my nod, as does Michael Page. Chris Madden, who made his living on the bottom, mind you, is going to start up top.
Now that's going to get interesting. I think he's seen Superman in that red cape come flying by him, and he decided that I might want to take a peek up there and see what I can make work too.
Well, Jonathan Davenport did make a heck of a move, you're right, to get into that spot. But it's a whole different ballgame to catch the leader and then get by him. Let's see what Madden has in store as the green comes back out. So Madden will go to the inside where he made his living to get back in that spot, and it paid dividends. Chris Madden right back to the point. The bottom groove is the way to get around here tonight for the 44. High side momentum for Davenport. He'll go right back after him. Oh, and close quarters there on the front stretch.
Pushing and shoving. Contact being made. Three wide and really Shane Clinton. Casey Roberts squaring up. Davenport trying to get to it, but Chris Madden said, I got your kryptonite for you, baby, and I'm about to do it to you tonight.
Well, so far, so good for the 44 as he takes the number one spot. Clanton surrendered fourth to Ridley, tries to steal it back over three. Slide job in four. He'll take care of it. 18 laps in the books. 20 laps coming up. We're halfway this time, and we're going to see caution. No, we're not. Reese will get in. We'll stay under green. 20 in the books, 20 to go.
Chris Mann has found that secret high side, one of the fastest ways here at the Sonora Raceway at the Georgia's Baddest Bull Ring. Casey Roberts all under Clint as they go into turns 3 and 4. Oh, boy, what a race off turn 4. They scrap off to the line.
Shane Clanton has left a little on the table as he has already lost touch with Ridley and about to fall out of the top 5. So Shane Clanton's situation not getting any better when it looks like he might have had a shot for third. He's about to fall out of the top 5.
Shane Clanton came last week, got that car dialed in and on a very slick track. The track's a lot more hammered down. And it's throwing him for a little bit of a loop, but he's up on that high side. Look at that momentum run he got. And he's just going to power around Casey Roberts.
Absolutely. Casey Roberts keeps him within his sights. Speaking of sights, well, the sight for Chris Madden is going to get a whole lot busier now because he sees the back of the field. Davenport knows it. He's going to track him down. We've got 15 to go this time. It's about to get thrilling one more time.
Let's see if the vulture known as Chris Madden can pick up the scraps in the back of the field and work his way around them, because Davenport is starting to close up the gap. He's got the hook out on that 44, and he's pulling them close to him, and they come to the line.
Trying to land the big fish tonight is going to be Davenport as he goes after Madden at turn number 2. Side by side down the backstretch. Wheel to wheel, door to door in 3. They've got them 2 wide in front of the leaders. Something's got to give out of 4. Here comes Davenport to the inside, your new leader.
Batman versus Superman style rumble as they get into it. And Davenport is your new leader on turn number 2. He'll complete the pass. He's going to use lap traffic as a pick, and he's going to pull away from Mann coming to the line.
And we know the brakes work on the 44 because he had to get him out of turn number 2 or else he was going to run into Davenport. So now it's up to Madden to be the hound chasing the hare.
Oh, boy. He is hunting him down like a dog in heat. He is chasing that tail. Davenport, dealing with lap traffic, is going to allow the leaders to close up second place. We got a smoker out of Brazil as he heads into turns 1 and 2.
Well, the view isn't going to be very good for the leaders here shortly if they catch the 54 because he's throwing smoke out into corners. Speaking of smoke, Chris Smokey Madden is now 9 laps away from not winning this event, which we thought he certainly was going to do. Of course, still a lot can happen, Dwayne.
Brazil off the pace.
And it's going to be David Payne bringing out the caution. So much for that. Brazil is done. Payne has stopped. And that lead has...
As it got really hairy on a high-speed track and lap traffic, it's usually not a very good recipe as they mix together.
9 circuits remain, and the one-to-go signal has been displayed. Well, Dwayne, with 9 quick laps around Sonora, if we stay green, they won't see lap traffic. They'll settle it between themselves the right way. But what happens on this restart? Let's find out. We're going.
And the famous words of MC Hammer is Hammer Time on 4. Off into turns 1 and 2, Superman's gonna jump back up and fire away. Chris Mann's gonna fade back in second. The field getting single file as they head out of 3 and 4, Rick.
And here comes the 44 of Madden, saving the best for last. He's got the preferred line. Superman's got the high side momentum. Chris Madden's gonna try and set him up in the corners. It'll be 7 laps to go, and Madden is pulled alongside. He'll draw a bead on him and come up short at the line.
Davenport, a high side hustler. He's like digging up on that top side. He's got something working. He's keeping Madden at bay. But look at Joe Armistead all over Shane Clanton. They're battling up in a battle for the leads. Getting real good at the stripe, Rick.
Armistead wants a 5th finishing spot, but not right now. Madden has lost touch a little bit with the 116 of Davenport. 5 laps to go, and Superman continues to show the way.
Superman moving all around the speedway, trying to find the best, fastest line around the Sonora Raceway. Hasn't been here since it was asphalt, and he was in a legend car. He's making a grand return here to the speedway with less than 4 laps left. Madden charging it back up. He's coming for him with three to go this time by. You got a lap car sitting in the waits for Jonathan Davenport. He's going to try to pull it down. The bull horns are out for Superman Jonathan Davenport. The rest of the field grabbing the bull by the horns with two to go. Davenport's going to take the white flag. What a crossover move for Chris Smokey Madden. The field is getting mad. Davenport is getting rich. Watch out, little baby. Checker flag for Davenport as he takes the win. Madden will come home second. Kenny Collins will come home third. And Ridley fourth. And Shane Clanton will round out your top five.
And he's getting congratulations down there from the crew. Unstrapped already in the 116, about to climb out. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner of night number two, Superman Jonathan Davenport. Well, JD, not a bad way to spend the weekend here in the 116. I know you can't be with us tomorrow, but I think Weaver will breathe a sigh of relief when he gets in this car.
Yeah, I might have put a little pressure on him there. So he's going to have to win tomorrow now. But I can tell you what, he's a man driving that thing. He's got a different rack and pinion than what I usually run. That's the first time I've had an arm pump, and I can't tell you how many years. But, man, I feel like my left hand's going to fall off. But I got to think, you know, Randy, all of his crew, Chip Stone, owner. I don't even know the sponsors on this thing, but I know it's a fast hot rod.
No doubt about it, at Case of Schaefer's Oil. Well, you know, you've got 2016, a lot to do on the Lucas Oil Series, being the defending champion. But when you can climb in a car like this you're not used to, that just tells people all over the country, you're here for a long time to stay, and they got to fear you. There's just no two ways of looking at it other than that.
Yeah, I sure hope so, man. This is a Longhorn chassis, you know, by Weaver. They do an excellent job. This is one of the nice pieces in the pit area, if not the nice. But, man, I think I was thinking back earlier. I think it's been 15 years since I've been here, and I won my last trip here in a Legend car when it was asphalt. So I got to thank all these fans. I had a lot of friends down here. We hung out last night, had a good time. Man, I tell you what, it's great to win in my home state again.
It's always good when home cooking tastes the best. I tell you what, who's this guy here who just shook your hand? Hey, Weaver, come on over here real quick. Randy, before we take off from JD here, any pressure on you now? You look pretty damn good in that car.
No, the way I look at it, it's 1-0, so we're ahead of the game. So I'm just get in here and see what I can do tomorrow night. But, man, that was a good race. I was glad it was a good race for the fans. This racetrack, I'm telling you, I'm glad he's driving tonight. Maybe tomorrow this thing will slow down a little bit.
Well, you said it was kind of hard to drive as far as the rack and pinion, the steering on it. I guess you got a newfound respect for Weaver now, right?
Yeah, definitely. I sure do. You know, he's, you know, it's just whatever you get used to. You know, if I drive this thing a couple times, I'll probably be fine in it. But, you know, the racetrack was really fast. Doug Stevens, he done a great job with this racetrack. You know, he had all that rain and this clay. He's just learning it. But he's sure going to have one heck of a place for all these fans to watch races from now on.
I know you had fun out there. We had fun watching you. Good luck the rest of the year, but glad to have you here in Victory Lane tonight.
Thank you. Once again, thanks to all the fans, man. It's been awesome. Congratulations to Chris and Kenny. There we go, yeah. You know, it's definitely good to see Kenny run well.
Nice job, JD. Jonathan Davenport picking up the win tonight. Now we're going to talk to Chris Smokey Madden. First, second. What happened in turn one, Smoke? It looked like you pretty much saved it from stalling out, getting sideways and stopping. What happened down there in one?
Yeah, we just, when I got in the corner down there, we got in and it loaded up real bad. The carburetor loaded up right in the middle of the corner and it wouldn't take off. And I was just sitting duck at that point. But you know, great race. Congratulations, Jonathan, with the win. You know, fun. I think the guys that put this racetrack together, they got an awesome place here. It can be a lot of fun. So thank all the fans for coming out and supporting us tonight. You know, hopefully I'll all come back tomorrow night and see another good race.
I think they will. That was a great recovery back there and picking them spots back off. Track record holder, I guess, you know, all in all, successful night. Second is obviously not the winner, but you're a whole heck of a lot better than a lot of drivers were tonight. They're going to be chasing you tomorrow, I got a feeling.
Yeah, I mean, we were pretty good. You know, we long as we was in the lead and didn't have lap traffic to deal with, I was fine. You know, we had a good race car, but we didn't have a maneuverable race car to maneuver in traffic. I was just too tight. I couldn't steer behind them, and I just got myself in trouble there.
Got a feeling you're going to be one of those drivers to contend with tomorrow night for the win. Good job tonight. See you tomorrow.
Thanks.
Chris Smokey Madden coming home second. We'll get a quick word with the third place finisher. One heck of a run for him. One of his best finishes that we have seen. Kenny Collins out of Colbert, Georgia. That Collins signs. Elite One Trophies 1C. Kenny Collins, heck of a run, man. Way to go tonight. Great night so far. Can you do any better tomorrow? It's going to be tough.
I don't know. Y'all don't know how many times I've got up on Saturday or Sunday morning and watched Dirt on Dirt and imagine myself getting interviewed. This is my first one. I couldn't be no more tickled if we'd have won the race. This ain't about the third time we run the car, and it's just awesome to be competitive with these guys. I got to give most of the credit to my dad. I've been working 70, 80 hours a week, and he's done everything to this car since we got it. And my mom and my wife, she couldn't be here tonight. I'm really disappointed about it. I wish she could have been here. But her birthday was this week, so maybe that was part of it. And I got to thank Drew and Marcus. They helped tonight. And all the rest of my family, my grandparents, and everybody that helps us. And Gary Winger, he done a lot for me this weekend so far. And he's done a lot all winter for us. And I want to thank all my sponsors, Colin Signs, of course, all my customers, Seymour's Towing, Dockery Transport, Irwin Race Supply. My dad, he built the engine. It run flawless. And Longhorn Chassis, this thing is awesome.
You're going to have a lot more of these nights. Get used to it.
I hope so. I appreciate it. Thank you, guys.
Kenny Collins coming home third. Smokey Madden second, and your winner, Superman Jonathan Davenport.